In this video, we'll look at a phase diagram for completely miscible metals, and so it's a relatively simple phase diagram compared to the one we can have when we have partial miscibility, but it'll help to describe the behavior and the properties of the system. So what we're looking at, just a hand-drawn view, so these should be, of course, smooth curves, where temperatures plotted versus the mole fraction of bismuth. Of course, at high temperature, this region is all liquid, and low temperature, this is just a solid solution. And then in between, this region here is liquid plus solid. And so we're going to talk about a number of aspects of this diagram. First, let's look at this point corresponds to the melting temperature or solidification temperature for bismuth. And then likewise, this point is the melting temperature for antimony. What you notice then for the in-between region is that the melting temperature depends on the composition of the alloy. Composition solid or the solidification temperature, the composition of the liquid. And further, that the melting or solidification, depending on which direction we're going, for mixtures now, takes place over a temperature range. Whereas for a pure material, of course, it melts at just one temperature. So let's look at the case where we start with a liquid that's at 600 degrees centigrade and its mole fraction of bismuth is 0.6. And as we lower the temperature, when we get to this point, we start forming solid. So a couple things that are important to note. The solid that forms is, of course, has to be at the same temperature, and the composition of solid is quite different from the composition of liquids. So when we have liquid and solid in equilibrium, the liquid composition does not equal the solid composition. Liquid and solid in equilibrium have different compositions. So for this particular example, we had X of the liquid was 0.6, and then the mole fraction bismuth in the solid is about 0.2. So quite a big difference. Now, as we continue to remove energy and form more solid, and we move down along this line for the overall composition, we have this liquid composition and this solid composition. So both liquid and solid compositions increase as the temperature decreases. And eventually, of course, we're going to have all solid, and then we're back to the same composition. So when we're in between here, how much solid, how much liquid we have is determined by the lever rule, which is described in another video. So let's look what happens in the phases. We start out, the yellow just represents all liquid. So we get to this point, we're going to now have small amounts of solid dispersed in the liquid. It's still mostly liquid. And as we move further down, for example, to this point, so as we move to this point, here we're going to have more solid, and as we get very close, then these solid pieces are bigger, a much larger fraction is solid, a much smaller fraction is liquid. Then when we get to where we have all solid, we get to the solid phase. Now these particles, of course, the solids have gotten bigger and we'll have grains, so we'll have solid phase with the black lines indicating the grain boundaries between the solids. This is, of course, assuming we cool this slow enough that we stay in equilibrium, and then our composition, of course, the solid is the same as the composition of our star. And so the question we might want to ask is, why are these two materials miscible? And a lot of it has to do with they have really similar properties. And so if we look up the crystal structure, rhombohedral crystal structure, so they have the same crystal structure. They all also have the same electronegativity, 1.9, and they have similar atomic radiuses so that they can pack together into this crystal structure. Not identical, but similar enough that they're miscible as a result of their properties being similar. So this is the simplest type of solid-liquid phase diagram that we'll see, where we have one liquid and solid phase, we have no chemical compounds, no unusual behavior.